there are some nifty ways we can make money. But salvage has never been more lucrative than it is right now. To be precise here, the salvage missions, which pay you for destroying ships, or so to say destroying evidence. These personal missions, which often ask you to, well, destroy a ship somewhere in the asteroid belt of Yela. And the best part, this mission can be done with fracturing, and you don't even need to use the disintegration. This means you just need to break the ship apart and not actually destroy any of the pieces. Okay, so how does fracturing and disintegration work? The same way you enter your hull scraping mode, you press the M key. From there on, you may notice on the right side you have a lot of new suggestions. Alt plus W or Alt plus A or Alt plus S or Alt plus D. Alt plus W allows you to swap to fracturing and disintegration mode. You can swap between them by pressing the right click. And if you have the fracturing mode up, you need to be at a certain distance, actually a pretty close distance, I believe it was roughly 70 meters or perhaps even closer, and hold down the left key until you see this little bar in the center of your target fill up. After that, it is fractured and the simple ADK can be yours. And with a small ship like Vulture, you can easily grab the 80,000 payout ones. If you're fast enough, you can do it with roughly 2 minutes, perhaps a wee bit more. Even though these missions can pop up quite often, there's a possibility of, well, actually other missions appearing which don't pay you money for salvaging some of these vehicles and wrecks. And no, the Vulture cannot destroy the Hammerhead, or else that would be one of the easiest 250k you'd make. If you're wondering how or why this actually works, it's because the mission ship or the mission wreck is actually removed and they spawn in pieces of the same ship. The mission could also be done with the tow ship, by just moving the ship far enough away and earning money from that. But because they didn't really, I guess, predict, or perhaps they did predict, but they didn't really plan to do anything about it, the fracturing with the ship will now be more lucrative, at least for a while. They probably do have some plans to fix it, but as I understand, the main intent was to get the 3.22 out before Christmas, or perhaps even as soon as possible. And so there were bound to be some ways we could make money. Nifty ways that were just missed, or perhaps let through on purpose for the time being. Now, fracturing can also help you fill up your cargo hold a lot faster. This kind of makes me wonder if they will reduce or remove the current payout for these missions. As they have often stated, they want us to use the hull scraping tools and then disintegration to make money. This of course would mean we would need a friend or a big ship to stow all of these goods, because a little ship like Vulture will definitely need a crew to maximize profits on, well, work like this. While a ship like Reclaimer won't have any problems doing salvage because of its big size and tremendous storage base. Now that beast of course needs a crew and is more capable. You can easily use it to go after bigger ships, you can easily use it to go after the huge ships, which the Vulture cannot handle. Of course I'm talking here about the Hammerhead, but Reclaimer will also need a crew of at least 3, or perhaps even crew of 4 to optimize it. So salvage is definitely one interesting way to go, and there were bound to be exploits or bugs like this. I highly suggest you take advantage of this as much as you can, as I could easily make a couple of 100,000 with around 15 minutes. And if you're aggressive enough and lucky enough, I guess you can make, I would say maybe 2 mil an hour, perhaps more. And if you don't have a Vulture, well, that's a slight setback. Although, if you can afford it, you can buy it with the in-game money and get to work ASAP. So this was one nifty, interesting way 3.22 allows us to make money. I don't really expect it to last too long, but perhaps we'll have to wait and see. Most likely they're gonna adjust the money we make from these missions. So try to use it as often and as much as you can. Anyway, don't forget to like, subscribe, and thanks for watching.